This is a short photo story about a place called Dunino Den, which is over in Fife between St Andrews and Anstruther. You'll find it on the B9131. Basically, find Dunino Church and you'll find Dunino Den just below that. It's not far at all, only about 50 yards down the side of the church, next to the wall beside the cemetery. You'll see a sort of rock platform with a hole carved in it. It's a round hole, about 4 feet across and about 3 deep, under the leaves and muck that's at the bottom of it. Is it a baptistry? Is it some kind of sacrificial thing? Is it a sacred well? I don't know. There's also a footprint carved into the rock just next to it. And some fairly precarious steps leading down into the den itself. At the bottom of the steps on the left, there's a Celtic knot carved into the rocks. In the den, there are some rock carvings, for example, this Celtic cross. At the time of our visit, there was a wickerwork structure, some kind of phallic image, perhaps. My nearest guess is that this is meant to represent male energy. And on the other side of the clearing, a circular woven wooden structure, which one would take to be female energy. It's either a circle or perhaps a heart. Also found some nice bracket fungus. Here we're looking back up through the sun-dappled woods to the promontory where the hole is carved in the rock, and the steps are just between those two crossed over trees just off centre of the picture. The big round hole in the rock, or what could be a baptistry or sacrificial hole, is just at the top of this pile of rocks. And here is a slightly closer view of the steps between the crossed over trees. It's got a nice peaceful atmosphere. We went on a sunny day and it was quite pleasant. There's another rock promontory, slightly separated from the main wall of the den. The rock around the den is very interesting. It's very aged sandstone. Much of the rock face is honeycombed with lots of little naturally weathered holes in the sandstone. Into some of the pockmarks in the stone, or these natural holes, people had pressed coins and shells, and also a feather. Apparently there is a ley line that runs from Dunino over to Kellie, and below that on this map you also see Kellie Castle, which is worth a visit and has lovely gardens. This is Kellie from the east. Finally, a few pictures of the gardens in the grounds of Kellie Castle. We also saw an exhibition of sculpture.